Hi, this is Craig Harper. Come for a ride with me. On the right is Dean Norman. Golf's got a turbo motor and had a very good turn of speed. Very impressive. And now we come around the top corner on the formation lap. Everyone's trying to find out which gear to be in for the start. The field's been bunched up quite nicely here by Sam Tingle. And then we wait for the flag to drop. And we're off. Look at that. Off they go. That's my old car on the right hand side. Harper 7. And we blast down the straight. It's a good time to be cautious, actually. Everyone's trying to figure out where they are. The tyres are all cold. So much gravel flying in the air. Really destroyed the camera eventually. And the front of the car, of course. Down the main straight. Down to the flyover. And again, it's good to be a little bit cautious here and just stand back a bit. You never know who's going to have a brain fade. Looks like we can get a run of Dean out of the corner and see what happens in front of us. It's Ian Harden in his Toyota Turbo, I think it is. And in front of him is Philip Menard in BMW. Nice little car. Had some trouble later in the race though, unfortunately. You never know what the other competitor's going through. In this case, Eden's pulling away from me down this part of the straight in the Toyota in front of me. It's got quite a bit of power and it's got nice big slicks on there. But then interestingly here, he seems to slow down for some reason. As I say, you never know what they're going through, but it's odd that he slowed down so early for the flyover. Anyway, we'll have that. Thanks, Ian. Up ahead of me now is Fulminar and the blue turbo escort. In front of them, Eric, who's currently battling with a severe wheel vibration, that's why he's going so slowly, he comes in next. But you see that these two cars are having a real ding-dong. They're quite fast down the straight, but they don't, they're not so quick through the S's. You'll see how they just disappear now. I wasn't happy to run at their pace. It was a bit quicker than I'd like to run, given our tyre situation. But there you'll see now, Eric goes in and two of them disappear for the time being, as we put them back later. Just watching these two in front here briefly. Phillip's in the car behind, it's a BMW, and I wonder why he didn't tuck in behind and get the draft, since he's compromising his racing line into the flyover, and the draft would have probably helped him pass. Okay, what do I know? So these two, from now on, these two pull away and it gets a bit quiet until we start lapping slower cars. At this point we're lying sixth. And the few laps later, now we're starting to catch the slower cars, and it's always fun, but also a little bit nerve-wracking coming through slow traffic. You wonder if they've seen you and if there'll be enough space for you to come through. Of course, here we have Bob on the right and Mark on the left. So you've just got to wait your turn to get through. Bob, give us some space and plenty, Bob. Strangely, I seem to catch this Toyota here every single time. Watch his front shocks. How he didn't end up in the bush, I just won't know. Anyway, that was funny. I caught him there several times, just there. We have Garth Citroen, I'm sure it's him, in his little Citroen. Handled beautifully, but I'm sure next year he'll have some more power, because he needs a bit more of that thing called power. This is a Ford Sierra, or Sapphire, I'm not sure which. Ran very, very well, very consistent, very reliable. I think they must have finished well in the race. There goes Sam Tingle in his little speeds. Very, very fast little motor car, but it seems to be maybe a bit fragile for this race. Out of the top corner onto the main straight, you're behind Dean Norman again and Phil Menar Sr. and his Lancer. You see that Golf's got good legs. I'm not drawing up on him at all at this point in time, and doesn't seem like I will catch him until the end of the straight. And I know what happens next, so I'll just talk you through it. So we're going down and got a complicated now, but it's slowed down really early for the flyover, before even the first brake marker. So maybe his dad and we have a chat about that. Alright, this is a bit of fun. So I'm coming up behind a Corolla or 11 and a Nissan Skyline GTR. And that was quite a cool move, maybe a bit risky. They didn't seem to be coming across, so I got away with it, but it was fun too. Ahead of us now is James Alexander and his Imp, powered by a 1.8 litre VW engine. First time it's raced, so he had some trouble later, unfortunately, but the car ran very well until he had to stop. Cheers, Jim. Ahead of us now it's Bob Beaver and his Bruce Gasby prepared, I wouldn't say Bruce Gasby prepared, but certainly Bruce did a lot of work with him on that car, and it's ran like a little cock. Beautiful. It'll be now one of the Corollas, I think. No, it's a little Conquest. So pick our way past him, and here we go, on the inside. Very nice. Top corner again. there, a few cars ahead of us now, starting to regularly pass the slower cars. This is Ian in his BMW. That guy did the 1 hour bike race and the car race, so that's Jimmy in his Golf ahead of us now. I can catch a run on him. Out the fiver, and let us come through. And there's Darren Pradji of Stalin Auto. Beautiful Datsun 1200. Not that it's a Datsun 1200 anymore, as it stands, with the same motor as my car. But beautiful. Lovely. Cheers, Darren. And down through the flyover again, coming past, is it Mark, I think, Martin, in his little turbo Starlet, into turn three, and ahead of us is a Corolla, I would say. There were a few of them, just going round and round, I think they're X-Rally cars. Whoop, and there goes Darren up the inside, you can see him coming. Look at that thing going. It sounds like a rocket cannon, it is like a rocket. Not that through the S's. That's not where that car's kicked. It's got such a powerful unit, power unit. It just absolutely disappears down the straights. So for next year, we have to go a little bit quicker. That's a fact. Darren go now. He's the car immediately in front of me, and he just hits warp speed. Very impressive to watch. Didn't I mention that Toyota? Here he is again, exactly the same place, bouncing his way down the straight. That poor guy was really battling an evil handling car. That's Philip. The two Philips actually ahead of me, in the Polo and in the BM, but I think at this point Philip Minow was hitting some trouble. The car wasn't performing at 100%, which is why we closed up on him again. Coming tight like that, it's not quite flat out. So it's a very nice, very fun corner. Here's Hamish Cameron, I think it is Hamish. One of two very nice, nicely prepared Super 7s. And Ian, his son Brett, very, very well in this race. On standard tyres, so he's got much less grip than I do. Thank you, Hamish. What a gentleman. He'll be up the inside. There goes Sam in the speeds, and thanks to Sam, Bob moves over and lets me come through as well. Don't mind if I do so. Catching this Toyota 11 here, I can see that you're not going to get him before the corner, so just blend it out the power and then see what can be done. There's no point in rushing up behind these cars and getting boxed in, which is precisely what happens to me next as we come down and I want to go past, but there's no plan with the BM there, and we just have to wait and try the other side. That was a successful move. We'll be right back. cars going slowly, watching each other and watching what's going on behind them. Things can go wrong very quickly, but these lads were perfectly gentlemen and I was able to come through. Out the top corner, there goes Eric in his Lotus 23. Beautiful little car, beautiful driven. They finished second on the day. Very conservative. They're running 25 and they could run 20. So it shows they had a lot of time in their pocket. And you'll see now how easy he was going into the flyover and how gently. That car's on slicks and he should be a lot quicker than I was. Probably means I was pushing a bit too hard, to be honest. Now watch how he disappears up the backstrap. He's just gone. That little car's got a real, really good turn of speed. If you remember how I keep catching that Toyota on the kink, similarly I seem to keep catching James on this corner, almost a photo copy of the previous pass. It's funny how it works out like that. Up ahead of me now, it's Bullet Cameron and his championship winning Lotus 7. Same engine as mine, slightly less power I'd say, and inferior tyres, and I think inferior aerodynamics. So it's quite quick down the straight, must be a nice light car. Can't quite haul him in before the corner, so just bide my time and then see what happens next. I'd squeeze it on and I think Blip might not have known I was there because he got himself boxed in behind Mark. You know, honestly, a sports car makes the driver look so good. Look at that. That poor guy in the Corolla, he was just struggling to grip. And guess who and guess where? Third time I passed him down here. It's the bouncing Toyota. Mind the bushes. Come up on Bobby down the end of the straight. As I go past him, he moves to the right. It gave me quite a moment. I had to avoid him. I don't think he knew I was there. Anyway, there was no harm done. I'd hate to have made contact. Here's where the gears go. I look for third gear now, and nothing happens. And that's hard, I think to myself. Fourth is there, but there's nothing else. And it's confusing at first. You don't know what's going on. You're looking around and tapping. So at this point I'm not sure if I've got any gears, and then I see I do have four. So down to the pits we go, we'll try to fix it. It was just a cable that came adrift in the fitting, but we couldn't fix it properly and we had to finish the race. Yeah. That's the way it goes. You do well, you must have a clean 3 hour with no trouble. Anyway, that won't happen again and we look forward to tackling this race again in 2015 with the same car, but quite a bit more speed.